The topic of this review was born out of the questions that many of you have when it comes to Shapeshifter for After Effects and Invigorator Pro. What are the similarities and differences between the two? Is one better than the other? What is the best use for each plugin? I am Tutor Ted Jalisco, and these are the topics I will try to answer. I will not go into depth or detail or advanced techniques. What I will show you is pretty basic, but it will help you understand how each plugin works. I will try to illustrate also what each plugin can be used for and the differences between them. I will highlight workflow differences and give you my opinion regarding the best use for each plugin. I have been using After Effects for a long time. If you heard about Cosa, then you will have a good idea for how long. I was always a believer in the possibilities and the future of the workstation and programs like After Effects. And I started my career in motion graphics and visual effects on a flame, but I wanted to do it home, although I was able to do it work, especially when it came to 3D stuff. So I got really excited when Zaxxverse came out with Invigorator Pro and Pro Animator. Then Freeform came bundled with After Effects, and that was a big step. And then Metal brought Freeform Pro and Shapeshifter for After Effects, and that was really cool to have all those new features brought into After Effects. Also, the new features in Invigorator Pro version 5 helped me to do a lot more of what I wanted inside of After Effects. So I use these plugins in my projects, but now let's start looking at a very basic project that will illustrate the difference in workflow and in result between Shapeshifter for After Effects from Metal and Invigorator Pro version 5 from Zaxxworks. Let's say you have a logo, yours or a client's. You want to have a 3D animation and a 3D look to it. Not just flat cards in 3D space, but you do not have the money, or maybe the time, or the knowledge to build a 3D model, to animate it, to render, to bring that into After Effects and composite that into your piece. Well, you can use Shapeshifter for After Effects or Invigorator Pro to do just that. Shapeshifter extruded shapes of all kinds, shape layers, vector files from Illustrator, text in After Effects, or in any image with an alpha. Also, by using displacement maps, you can displace the shape or image to create 3D objects with complex detail. So what I had to do is to go inside Photoshop and create two layers, one with the image of the logo, and that would be the texture for my 3D logo, and then the other, a black and white image, my depth map, that will determine the displacement. To create the depth map, I brought the saturation down to zero so the image becomes just shades of gray, and then I used the selection tool to isolate the shapes and change the levels of gray. The basic idea of a depth map is that 50% gray is the middle plane of a surface. Whatever is lighter goes up or towards the camera, and what is darker is down below the surface or away from the camera. With just two layers, I am ready to build my logo in After Effects. If I know the font and I have it loaded, I can build the logo entirely in After Effects with complete control for the displacement map, bevel, or even the way the letters animate in to build the logo. If you use text, you can also benefit from the animation presets and have your text animate in to build the logo. Bevels can be created in the depth map. Metal has even a free project file for bevels and styles that you can download from their website. By using a third image as a reflection map, I can create a different look for my logo. All of these with really fast feedback, which allows for ease of animation and in-depth tweaking done in a familiar After Effects interface. You can use filters directly on the layer, or you can pre-compose the layer of the texture or the depth map and apply effects to generate a different look. I will stop here and discuss later some of the other features of Shapeshifter, but I will go over to Invigorator Pro to see how the logo can be built there. In Invigorator, you can import a variety of 3D files, but you can also extrude text or vector files from Illustrator. In order to be able to build this logo, I had to do a bit of work in Adobe Illustrator. I traced the logo and saved the file as version 8. I was able then to import that into Invigorator and extrude to the desired depth. You can use also basic shapes to create, let's say for this logo, the background. I created that using just a couple of basic shapes inside Invigorator. Bevels are easy. One click away, or I should say, one drag and drop away. Using the numerous presets and invigorator, you get a lot more bevels and really fast. If you really want to get into it deep and create your own bevels, you can even draw that and use that into invigorator. When it comes to bevel and textures, I think Invigorator is much more complex and offers you a lot more presets. Texturing is easy. You can choose from one of the many materials available. You can build your own, make it as complex as you want. Use bump maps, reflection maps, many layers. There's also a few styles that come as presets, and that can make your life easier and your workflow faster. If you do a lot of work involving 3D text that needs to be beveled and you need fast access to textures or styles, Invigorator Pro, I think, would be the choice here. But if you are thinking about animation, how you want to animate that text, well, it's not as easy to use, and the interface is not as straightforward. You will need to learn a different interface, one that may intimidate you a bit, and if you're not familiar with 3D programs. Animation takes also a bit of practice, because you can link a 3D object to a 3D layer in After Effects and animate that layer, but you will need to update to see the preview, and you don't get that fast feedback. However, that can be dealt with, and you will see later in some of the examples of the work I will show you how that can look. Invigorator allows you to use native After Effects cameras and lights, but also offers cameras and lights within the plugin itself. Here are the results of the two projects side by side. I think both look really good, and up to this point I could see that picking one plugin over the other could be hard. I guess it could be decided by the type of projects you work on or the workflow you're more familiar with. What I want to show you, though, are the things that are different and unique in each of the plugins. Shapeshifter, as well as Freeform Pro, benefits from what can be called a particle system, the generator. With it, you can create and manipulate multiple instances of the same object. This allows for some really cool animations that are easy to create, with fast feedback and reasonable render times. Also, there are other ways you can affect objects using 3D deformation, bend, bulge, or twist. And here are some examples of animations done using Shapeshifter for After Effects. Invigorator Pro, on the other hand, can create animations with more complex 3D objects that were modeled and textures in a 3D application externally. With more and more free or low-cost 3D model libraries out there, the ease of doing pretty complex 3D animations in After Effects has increased. The textures can be edited and changed, the models animated, and you get fast previews and the benefit of all the effects After Effects has to offer. I have often used various 3D plugins in combination with Invigorator to achieve results that before were possible only in a dedicated 3D application. Here are some examples of various types of work done with Invigorator Pro. Thank you. What is my insight? I have and I use both plugins, sometimes separate and sometimes together. They both have strengths and unique features that fit best one kind of project or another. I will say that I consider both of them necessary if you're serious about 3D work in After Effects. And the new features for both plugins that will be available in the next release are really, really enhancing their capabilities. For more examples and in-depth information, check out the website for each plugin and browse the large number of tutorials available on the web. I hope that this review has clarified some of your questions about Shapeshifter AE from Metal and Invigorator Pro from Zaxworks. Signing off, this is Tutor Ted Jalisco.